Hey, this is Pals from Neck Deep.
Sam from Neck Deep.
And you're listening to Total Rock.
Total Rock, I'm very excited. I'm meeting the boys of Neck Deep in Cologne, just starting your European tour. Brought the lovely winter weather with you guys.
Oh, yes.
But we're talking about an upcoming album, a massive tour of Europe. We're going to talk about the US a little bit. You came back from the Far East. There is an Ali Pali show. You're not smiling enough after all these great announcements. How are you guys doing?
Good.
Yeah, good.
Be excited about everything that we've just done and everything that we've got coming up. It's one of the most exciting times for us. So excited for the record to get out. I wish we could leak it tomorrow.
So let's talk about that. First of all, it's called a title album. Mm-hmm. Fifth album. What changed? Why is it finally the self-title? What's different about it? Also self-produced. So what brought those two changes?
For self-titled, we did have a few names come in like that were placeholders for what we wanted the record to be called, but it just felt like we created the record that we were supposed to and fans will love and relate and know the band historically for. And yeah, we did try and go do the album in LA in March and it didn't really work out. It sort of was taking a turn that we didn't want it to kind of sound like, and we felt like our songs were running away from us. So we came back to Wales and Seb produced the whole thing, which the last record for that was Wishful Thinking. So, and obviously since then and now, like, there has been some lineup changes and now Seb's in the band as well. So it just felt like we put so much into this and we really didn't have anyone else steering the ship. So it was just us doing through. We made the songs, we changed the songs, we sat on the songs, came back, revisited, changed lyrics, and like we had a bit more freedom than we've ever had. And it just felt like self-titled was the record. Yeah. This was that record.
Nothing stuck more than it being self-titled, did it? Like, the self-titled suggestion was like everyone felt the most confident being like, actually, yeah, you know.
If
there's ever a time, this was the one, yeah.
So, if we can talk a little bit about the themes of the album, there are three singles right now out that we were already exposed to. One of the latest ones is It Won't Be Like This Forever. Mm-hmm. If I'm not mistaken, was actually kind of written with COVID in mind, with lockdown in mind. Did I get that wrong? Is it an influence of the album in general?
Well, that was the first song. One of the first songs written. So in the pandemic, when they first let us see people again outside of your area code, postcode, the first thing for us to do was meet because we hadn't seen each other for a year. So we met up, we got an Airbnb and we were just like, let's just get together, write some songs and see what happens. We've been doing some ourselves at home individually. Let's bring them together. And as we were working on some songs, I was just playing some chords and Ben came out of the toilet and sang the whole chorus of It Won't Be Like This. Just had it like that, which we couldn't believe. And so that was one of the first solid things we had for this album. And we also did Shut the Fuck Up was sort of done there. So it was like quite a while. We did this album in so many different periods. But yeah, I think that was one where It Won't Be Like This Forever and typical, or what fans, you know and love about Neck Deep is, like with Life's Not Out to Get You, like there is always this silver lining of perspective and shift that focus and look at the positives rather than just getting like weighed down with the negatives and beating yourself up about it. So that song definitely resonated and felt like it was written and we all were able to just immediately relate to it as of, you know, the tail end of a pandemic. So yeah, that means a lot to us as well. I'm one of the first ones to sort of like be solid and this will be an album song. Let's see what else we've got. So yeah, that felt really good.
we're kind of still at that point that we don't know a lot about the album. There are three singles out there. I just looked at the names, the titles of the songs, and it feels a bit angry or maybe even disappointed, but I wasn't even sure if it's directed at us or the listeners. So who is the main figure, the recipient? Who needs to hear that?
I feel like it changes. I feel like every song changes the angle or the point or perspective. Like, if you said you read the title, like, they may not mean to, but they do, is a wildly, you know, subjective topic. So, and it shifts, you know, there's like, yeah, I feel like I can't really say much more without going into it or trying to give away loads, but...
It's not about self-loathe or a specific person that we're hating on.
It's, and almost every song changes theme, yeah.
Yeah, there's you know, We Need More Bricks is a political based song.
Yeah.
Which Nick Deep has always had, you know, threads of that through some of the songs, and that's awesome. I think that's a really well written song lyrically by Ben.
Go outside, does what it says.
Yeah, go outside and, you know, get some air.
Get some air, you know,
especially after the pandemic. And then there's just, you know, there's some breakup songs, you know, things that fans will love and relate to and just sort of expect from an Nick Deep record. But it's definitely not aimed at anyone specific, or maybe, yeah, in hindsight, some of the titles maybe do appear that way, like Moody Weirdo. But Moody Weirdo is like a song that's like an uplifting song, kind of like, you know, if you go to therapy and you get some of these feelings out and you have a new perspective, a new way to like reframe.
And Ben does this thing a lot, I've noticed over the years with lyrics, where if he's writing a song that seems like it's pointed at somebody, he always also sort of levels himself as part of the thing. Do you know what I mean? Like, if it's at you, it's at me too. Which I think makes for a good whole topical subject.
Yeah, but I would say overall it's not sort of negative.
And yeah, like, there's no
negative. How like Shut the Fuck Up was, for instance, which is like, ah, the world's, you know, this way. Even though it was done in a more light-hearted, fun way, it certainly isn't we're mad at the world or anything like that.
Yeah, it's
I would say there's more relatability, like Life's Not Out to Get You and some of them songs and messages and themes running through on this record. Even though maybe some of the titles seem different, which I hadn't really thought about.
I think it's because
we know the songs.
Yeah, right.
We know the meanings.
Honestly, we all still kind of call them by the demo names just because we're so used to it. I can't remember the song names half the time. I feel like they're quite different titles than Nick Deep songs usually look like.
Yeah, there was some time spent into
Usually I ask a question and I throw myself under the bus because I see it in a specific way. Obviously, you see it in kind of the band's way and maybe even the lyricist's way, so you know what the main story behind it is. And then we as the fans can kind of do whatever we want with it.
Yeah.
And then again, I throw myself under the bus. But I also felt like over the last couple of years, pop punk kind of became the sad boys club, like a lot about mental health, about dealing with stuff. If metal's a bit more the aggression, the release side, and then pop punk is more, why cry about it when you can just pop punk about it? Is it something that you relate to as well, or am I just seeing it my way?
I don't know, emo more so in the...
I think the two of them maybe kind of joined hands or replaced each other.
They did, but I feel like that's not all... like pop punk acts, that's maybe some of the like MGK TikTok act and things like that, which maybe aren't like through and through pop punk. It's maybe some of the just like themes that have ran recently. But I wouldn't say Nick Deep's sad boy.
No, not at all.
And I just thought as well, like, because I was trying to think of what the titles were on the album. So song two is called Sort Yourself Out, which sounds quite aggressive. I understand that, but our other title, which we know, was Flowers, which is completely contrasting.
And it's also Dumbfuck.
Dumbfuck, Dumbstruck.
Yeah. So it felt to me like a bit of self-loathing, but again, it could be about somebody else.
Yeah, about almost yourself, basically. And that's a, you know, pretty positive. That's a fun one. That's one of my favourites on the record. But yeah, those... some of the titles, yeah, maybe do sound a little
Finding that silver lining, but still coming from mental health, very much aware of that. Sometimes maybe even not liking yourself and then still trying to cheer yourself up. So kind of taking a left turn from emo and finding that silver lining, as you guys said. So do you accept that, or am I, again, completely off?
No, I think we said that, and I quite like that the names actually are quite opposite to what the actual like content of the song is. So,
and I feel like you can align them to how you feel. Okay. You know, there's different ways you could look at them, for sure.
Okay.
Okay, so let's talk about something a bit more positive. Heartbreaks. So you guys released a very lovely video of you guys winning awards for the best breakups ever. Do you feel like you guys are the masters of breakups or romance? Would you title each other as one of these two?
We've definitely got some heartbreak songs, definitely. And there's a few more to be released as well. But that was just a fun idea which Ben had, and we wasn't sure whether we'd be able to sort of pull off that music video, but Max Moore once again coming in with a really awesome team and treatment. But yeah, maybe we've got a lot of heartbreak songs, so maybe it's right that we sort of give ourselves the award for the heartbreaks.
Is it true that the band's going to start a podcast or a love line support for fans and giving some love tips?
Has that been rumored?
Yeah, I can't see that in the near future.
No, it's not going to happen?
I don't know. You're
not going to lead this.
I wouldn't know where to start.
Maybe if there's another pandemic,
we'll
do a podcast. It's quite hard. We all live in different parts now. We all live quite spread out, so it's quite hard to do a lot in the in-between of tour. A podcast would be fun.
It would be fun. It would be fun.
I'm not sure we're the best people to give out advice for...
Yeah. Wake up at 4 a.m. in the morning. Work out by 5.
Sounds great. And we also got introduced to your acting skills, and the internet is gushing with rumors about the band calling it quits after this album and joining Hollywood, becoming film stars. Is that true?
God, we would be out of the dumps doing that. That took us so many takes. It was so awkward. That was the one thing we were like,
I've watched the bloopers.
Do we have to do the acting bit? And Max was like, yeah, it's really going to help. We really should do it. And it took us so many. Had like two lines, or not even, a few lines. And you go over them, you can say them immediately back and forth. And the second it's like action, it's, what's the first line? What's the first one? What's the first word? It just immediately gone. So West was the funniest doing his parts, because he just couldn't remember his lines at all. It was just, in the streets of Louisville.
I would recommend watching the bloopers reel, so that just adds to the sounds and adds to the video. So I'm guessing Brad Pitt can sleep quietly and not be scared for his next job.
I think he's safe. I think
he's
safe.
Very safe, yeah.
Let's talk about the album one more time. So it's coming out January 19th. Self-titled.
It's his birthday.
Oh, wow. That's a really nice way to celebrate that. So now we need to talk about a launch party. I'm going to ask about that in just a second. But I always like asking about collaborations. Any surprises that we can expect from the album? Are there going to be aliens on the album? What should we expect? We have a few more months before that comes out.
No collabs.
No collabs.
Again, thought about it. We almost had one on ADAI. We had the perfect collab, and we ended up not doing it. But on this album, it's one of them where you don't want to force it, but if there's a part that comes up that feels like, oh, this would be awesome if we got this person to sort of guest on the song, but nothing really felt, you know, nothing stuck out that another voice or person would benefit the track. So no features, and all the aliens are already on Take Me With You. That's that one. Yeah, would have been good to have tumbled along on that track.
Yeah, that would have been perfect. Like, yeah, the week Blink announced they were back, and then that song comes out.
But now, unfortunately, no collabs yet.
Oh no, it wasn't. Sorry, it was the week that the US did the alien hearing. Then to have Tom along, and it would have been awesome. Yeah.
It would have been great.
Next time, I'm sure that the US is going to announce some weird things in the future, so there's always a song just waiting to happen.
We'll have one ready.
And you guys are going to the US in January. There's one show in Ali Pali in March.
Correct.
Can we talk about some UK shows, launch shows, birthday party?
Don't know about anything other than Ali Pali.
Yeah, I mean, we may get into trouble, but we're looking at doing some stuff before the record comes out in January, but we're just trying to figure out what logistically works. So maybe some acoustic in-store things to celebrate. There may only be a few just down to time frame. And then in terms of touring, we're currently trying to work that out for schedule, because we've got some other stuff which isn't announced yet.
I'm going to ask about that in a second. I have a feeling I know where you're going.
Oh, no.
Because I think just a couple of weeks ago you did, was it Rain in July shows? And we're getting really close to the 10-year anniversary of your debut. Is that the reason behind your smile right now? Is that?
Oh, no.
But sometimes fans think about that more than the band.
Wishful thinking.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
None of that.
No, there'll be no... There won't be... Sorry, anyone that's expecting
yeah,
that.
It's a new record.
There won't be... There won't be an anniversary tour. Because that's the thing, is if we did an anniversary tour of each record, they're all coming up. You know, by the time Wishful Thinking's done, it's then Life Started to Get You in 2015, and 27... You know, 2027 would be Peace in the Panic. 2019 would be 80... We'd have like a... It'd be like anniversary... album tour anniversary. So
I don't hear anyone complaining.
Yeah, I don't know about Wishful Thinking. No. I'm not convinced enough people want to hear that record.
I'm not convinced,
but I'm sure there will be some things for Lifestyle to Get You in 2025, so they I'm sure that'll be happening. But in terms of UK Europe stuff for this, you know, for the self-titled record, we're just figuring that out, figuring out around some like festivals and things like that. So hopefully announced this year, or it'll be at some point into early next year when we have that all organized and announced. But it's definitely happening. Yeah.
So as we said, the self-titled album is out January 19th, going to be in the US in January, Ali Pali in March. Mm-hmm. Anything else you want to say to fans out there before you say goodbye?
Get the record.
I hope you like the record. You know, we took all thoughts about ADI on board, and this record means a lot to us. We feel like this is truly us through and through. Very passionate about making a full like pop punk, you know, all killer no filler. Not the Sum 41 title, but yeah, just trying to not do any, let's just put that track in, and you know, making sure we get 10 tracks that feel good, would feel good live. And yeah, so hopefully everyone enjoys it, and yeah, we'll be having much more touring, and then it'll be anniversary stuff and all of that. Yeah,
sounds
excited
great.
For it all.
Yeah, me too, guys. I cannot wait to see you on stage and enjoy the album in just a couple of weeks. Thank you guys very much for your time.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Thank you.